Previously on X-Men.
In the fall of 2010, Dr. Victor Von Doom attempted to take over the world, starting with the New York Comic Con / Anime Festival. His plans, however, were thwarted by the timely arrival of Canadian pugilist and sometimes rock star, Scott Pilgrim. Due to the Latverian financial crisis that ensued in the wake of Doom's defeat, Doom did the most logical thing he could do to save his enslaved nation. Namely, sue Shadaloo's dictator, M. Bison, for copyright infringement. 5 months into what has become known as the Trial of the Century, every available high-powered lawyer imaginable has been hired and, quite literally, fired. And now the case rests on the shoulders of the two most famous lawyers across the multiverse, both being dragged into a case that neither of them should be involved in. Seriously. The fate of two worlds now hangs in the balance on the greatest stage of them all. The courtroom! One more crossover. One more battle. This is the moment you've all been waiting for. Heaven or hell, let's rock!
We now return you to BeamSpam TV's coverage of the Trial of the Century. BeamSpam TV, breaking combos and news since 1987.
All rise for the Honorable Judge. You gotta be kidding me. Really? The Honorable Judge Wade Wilson.
Every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling,
every day I'm hustling, got those girls just rustling.
Judge Deadpool at your service. Now, what do I get to make into the next William Hung?
Your Honor, you do know this is a legit trial, right?
Wait, you mean this isn't the X Factor USA? You jerks lied to me! this chair's comfy, and I can get this engraved gavel for nothing.
Yo, D! I mean, oh, come on. Your Honor, that's a gun with a hammer taped to it.
Tomato, tomato, gavel, gun. Bring in the guys suing each other!
All rise for the defendant and his legal team.
I hope you prepared yourself right. I'm not paying you to lose this case.
I hardly consider holding my legal team hostage as payment.
All right. I should probably tell someone to feed those hostages, too. Maybe after opening statements.
All rise for the plaintiff and his legal team.
Okay, so you promise me you're the real Doom?
You dare question Doom's bravery in the face of an adversary?
Besides the obvious fact that this is mistrial number 8 due to exploding decoys, and the fact that you got hooked up by Squirrel Girl once upon a time.
Speaking from experience, that tends to happen a lot, I've noticed.
This suit is Armani, and I'm allergic to explosions. Oh no. Not you!
Yes, you bullseye-killing whack job! Me! Now keep it down!
I'm trying to beat this level in Angry Birds.
If it helps, with any luck he'll shoot himself with his own gavel.
We can only hope.
Wait a minute. Glancing about the so-called courtroom, I cannot help but notice that the current iteration of this baseless trial is inherently rigged in Doom's favor.
You know, I didn't want to say it, but I'm also kinda noticing the Marvel-heavy courtroom here. I also hate to say it, but much like any major Marvel event, it's kinda taken forever to get anything done.
Oh snap, son! That burn was downright fierce! Get it? Burn? Downright?
Screw you, right? If it wasn't for poor quarter two sales, the only crossover you'd get to be in would be the one with a top hat wearing fop who hangs out with little boys. Am I right?
If this is the way this trial is going to go, this one is in the bag! You better not ruin this for Doom!
Noted. If I may begin with my opening statements. Ladies and gentlemen of the court, my client is the victim of injustice.
Horse crap! This charade that you call justice is an inherent injustice. There isn't even a jury. Just a collection of action figures the court clearly stole from the dealer's room. They're still in their boxes, for God's sake.
Pro tip. My job gets harder when you open your mouth like that. Fact. We lose the case when that happens.
Fact. I can ruin you like Hollywood ruined Mario Brothers. And Double Dragon. And Tomb Raider. And...
If you have any mercy, Mr. Murdoch, please continue!
And I thought OJ's lawyers had it bad. Injustice! Not only in the mass slaughtering of innocent Latverians at the hands of Shadaloo operatives.
Doom weeps when one mentions the most tragic day in Latveria's history.
Oh, please, you call that a tragedy? For me? It was a Tuesday.
Gah! Is Doom the only one who can truly see what a jerk that guy is? Seriously.
Overruled! Only Deadpool can speak out of turn and in the third person. Continue.
But injustice in one of the most hallowed institutions on God's green earth. Copyright protection. Not only has Mr. Bison...
General Bison, thank you. I didn't violently oppress all those people for nothing.
Permission to have that last statement stricken from the record?
Sorry, already tweeted it. No backsies.
Yeah. What General Bison has done is infringe on everything that makes Mr. Doom...
Doom is a doctor, dammit! Doom has a PhD in rage and vengeance!
With a minor in creative writing.
Dr. Doom unique. Namely, running a third world country with totalitarian impunity, numerous attempts to destroy the United Nations, and being foiled each time by an American jerk with a derp hairstyle.
Objection! First off, Dr. Doom wears green. General Bison clearly wears red.
Objection! Mr. Wright, need I remind you, I'm not just colorblind. I'm all kinds of blind.
Sustained! Anyone who wears a yellow and brown costume that ridiculous is definitely blind. Just saying. Continue, Mr. Wright.
Thanks, Your Pooliness. Secondly, while the two do oppress a third world nation, Dr. Doom's nemesis clearly wears blue, whereas General Bison's clearly wears green.
Objection! Again, blind. And as I was told, that Van Damme lookalike clearly wore blue in the movie.
Objection! Wow, that's fun to say. That movie was awful, and y'all are banned from referring to it again!
Also, one more outburst like that, and I'll find you in contempt. Only I may break the fourth wall. Hi, Peter! Regret allowing this skit to happen yet?
Getting back on point, however, General Bison is not a mere copycat. He is what makes America great.
Says the Japanese guy.
Not according to the localization. Anyway, he's what makes America great. He's a better version of the original. Much like Coke tweaked Pepsi, GoBots tweaked Transformers, and Avatar tweaked Ferngully Pocahontas and Dances with Wolves, General Bison has tweaked superpowered dictatorship just as well as Donald Trump.
Objection! Much like General Bison, your defense is a cheap knockoff. I saw that episode of It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. Well, heard, anyway. And read the subtitles in Braille, courtesy of Hulu Mobile.
Wait, why would you need to read the subtitles if you can hear the dialogue?
I wanted the full experience. There's a reason I dropped Netflix altogether and started paying for Hulu.
Sustained! Premium Hulu deserves a full experience. Also, please refrain from any more FX references. Seriously! Half the audience can't afford to pay attention for more than 5 minutes, much less pay for basic cable.
Ah, nuts. Since I'm too poor to pay for basic cable and secretly too cheap to stay with Netflix to keep up on all those great FX shows I used to watch on there, I can't keep up with these pop culture references. And Bison never flew out my legal team because he's holding them hostage, so I can't even get help from my hot dead boss. Ugh. This is the part of the trial I hate. You know, where the grand turnabout usually happens. But no matter what I do, I'm screwed. If I find a way through Murdoch's logic, Doom will probably kill me. If Murdoch keeps shattering my arguments worse than Glee with its second season storylines, then Bison will kill me. And if neither of us wins, I'm fairly certain the judge will kill me. Probably because he'll find it funny.
Yep.
What the fu- How are you in my head?
Superpower.
Ah! I can't even think straight because I have the freaking judge in my head. Oh, this is bad. This is real bad. There's so much pressure on me.
Phoenix!
What?
Danger zone!
Ah! I thought you said we weren't gonna make any more FX show references. That's it. No matter who wins, we all lose. Nothing can make this end in anyone's favor now. Nothing.
Bison's attorney is crumbling faster than Mega Man Legends 3! Feel the wrath of Doom's iron fist! Doom is king!
Not so, as Bison is the true king of the iron fist.
Yo, Fighting Game Scrub League.
Here comes a new challenger.
Last time I checked, my name literally is Iron Fist. So that makes me the legit king of this castle.
Prattle about being the king of Iron Fist all you want, losers.
Here comes a newer challenger.
All that got Namco was four mediocre sequels and a crappy live-action movie. And yes, I am aware neither of us has any right to talk about that.
Score! Saved by unnecessary additional crossovers.
Ah, excellent. Doom's surprise character witness has arrived. Now, once again, with the odds overwhelmingly stacked in his favor, Doom calls for another mistrial in favor of...
Dude, before you even think to suggest that, need I remind you, this is a court of law. We're trying to settle this with words and statutes, not hyper combos and fatalities.
Overruled! It's fighty time, blood, blood, blood.
Well, at least you tried. Team up.
Team up.
Oh. Apparently, I can't jump in until the Ultimate Arcade Edition. Oops.
Fuck you, and fuck the second quarter earnings you came here on!
And now that we've guaranteed we'll never be featured on CapcomUnity.com,
boys and girls, mutants of all ages, get your Pringles and grab your sticks!
It's Marvel, baby!
Select your character. Doctor Doom, Shang Tsung, M. Bison, versus Iron Fist, Deadpool, Phoenix Wright, Final Battle.
Again, the Iron Gauntlet of Doom reigns supreme over spandex-clad buffoons. And this time, there's absolutely no way that any man, woman, or Canadian will turn about this case. Get it? Turn about?
No. Nobody.
Well, too bad! Doom and his new allies will crush you beneath their boots, and then...
Not necessarily. Pop quiz, true believers. What happens when Phoenix is defeated with a full hyper combo bar?
But this is a spiky-haired enforcer of justice, not a banging, death-prone redhead in tights.
Ha! We're still in beta, fool! We don't ship till next month! I can do whatever I want!
Mayo! KO!
Ha! Doom still foils your plots by default! Choke on Doom's glorious bag of dicks, Dukeness!
Listen, Vic, I'm real proud of you, and I could continue to reference that Kanye West meme, but that blind dude is about to get all damages upside your shiny metal head.
Say hello to the most dangerous piece of paper in New York City! A parking violation!
The Baxter Building, headquarters of the Future Foundation.
But Doom is a member of that accursed outfit! Doom has a pass!
Just a moment, please. Yes, hello, Franklin. Put your father on. No, Doom doesn't care which Pokemon you caught today. Oh, really? That is impressive.
Doom means put your father on the phone now! No, Doom will not. He dares put Doom on hold? Richards!
Forget this. Doom will pay the fine. Now, where can Doom find an ATM?
Hey man, you okay?
A little burnt out from that hyper combo. No pun intended. Where's Doom?
Defeated in the most judicial way possible.
What? A $5 fee for not using an ATM associated with Doom's banks? Blah!
I can't help but notice that this violation is written on the back of a Dwayne Reed receipt. And the spelling is horrible. It looks like it was written by a blind guy.
Alright, so I may have forged a little evidence to save the day.
A lawyer doing something underhanded and sneaky? Color me shocked!
Well, if there's anything that I've learned from this experience, it's that sometimes we all have to do things that are a little bit out of character for the greater good. Whether it's pummeling the tar out of supervillains,
or writing fake parking tickets to troll dictators,
or peeing in Ryan Reynolds' cereal. What? Did you see Green Lantern?
As long as justice is served in the end, that's all that matters.
Because justice is blind.
Hold it!
Here comes a new challenger.
I do so hate to rain on your little morality parade, but you geniuses forgot to take into account the absolute power of rights acquisition! Gentlemen, CBS and David Caruso are suing all of you for unauthorized use of a trademarked gimmick.
Game over.
Irony!
Every day I'm shuffling. I'm shuffling.